Hey everyone, I have actually two stories to share with you today, all supporting the concept, paradigm shift really, that your life isn't for you, nor is it for others. It's actually for God. We're here to serve God. So that means some interesting things. It doesn't mean that you're always doing what you want to do, it also doesn't mean that you're always doing what other people want you to do, which, let's face it, that's typically what we do. From childhood, we're taught that we've got to serve other people. We've got to strive for that carrot, other people's expectations of us. And so when we wake up to the fact that our life isn't for other people, we tend to swing to the opposite end of the spectrum, thinking, our life is just for us. I'm going to do exactly what I want to do. And I'm gonna be who I want to be, and that's good. I actually think that that's better than thinking that your life is exclusively for others. But there's actually a third level, and that is to realize that you're here to serve. Yes, you are here to serve, but you're here to serve God, and by doing so, you start to shift into recognizing that that doesn't mean you're serving everyone. Everything at all times. That's actually not serving God. Serving God means using our blueprint to discern when to serve, where to serve, whom to serve. The amazing thing about God is he believes in the win-win. So when you're serving him, you're using your blueprint to discern when to serve, where to serve, whom to serve. Guess what? You also are served. And it totally makes sense. God's genius. He wants us to want to do the work that he wants us to do. He wants us to want to serve the people whom he wants us to serve in the places he wants us to serve them. So when we use our blueprint to discern whom to serve, where to serve, when to serve, we are filled. We're filled with energy. Enthusiasm, and guess what? He has also filled us already. We came preloaded with the skills we need to serve those people in those ways at those times. Super cool. It makes sense, doesn't it? We're designed by an infinitely intelligent creator. So it makes sense that not only would he preload us with everything we need, but it also means that when we do those things, when we serve in those ways, we too are served. So we're never running out of steam. We're never running out of ideas or resources. We're constantly filled with everything we need to do those things and serve those people. So this helps us do the discerning then. If we know that serving our people, the people God wants us to serve, doing the things that God wants us to do. If we know that by doing those things, we'll be energized, we too will be filled, will be served, then we can start to learn where we're supposed to be and where we're not supposed to be, who we're supposed to be with, etc. Now, this serving of God comes in every aspect of your life, whether in work, in volunteer activities, or in social activities. So, the two stories I have to share with you today, one is a client's, actually, two clients. And their vacation experience. And another one is a volunteer experience. So I just shared with you that you serve God 24/7, whether you're doing social activities, work activities, volunteer activities, gym activities, whatever. So the two out of all the ways that we serve God, I've got two examples, one social and one volunteer. So I'll share the social first. I have two clients, they're married. They went on a trip together, but they went with other people as well. So while they're at this location, this beautiful location, they have, as a couple, desires, things that they really want to do, blueprint. And then the other people that they're with also have things they want to do, also blueprint. So sometimes those desires jived with one another, and sometimes they didn't. And this couple that are my clients, they talked about feeling this kind of stretch, this pull, this uncomfortable pull between what they wanted to do and what other people wanted them to do. So this is an example of discerning, okay, God, which one do you want me to do? Do you want me to just go ahead and fill my tank and do what I want to do on this vacation? Or can I serve you better by going along with other people where they want to go and when they want to go, even if that's not what I want to do? So my clients, bless them, felt that they should do what other people wanted to do, but they felt resentment about that. And so it's super, super important, again, to recognize we're not here to serve us and we're not here to serve others. We're here to serve God. And that guides us to where and what we should do. And when we do those things, it fills us with that sense of energy and fulfillment. And back to my client's story with the vacation, it's hard to know what was right and what wasn't right. But again, the orienting factor for our decisions as to where we go, whom we serve, when we go, stuff like that, should be God and our blueprint, not our interests, our personal interests, nor others. Very, very interesting. Then the second story I have to share with you is my own. I volunteered for a certain committee at my church, and this committee had a meeting last night, and I attended the meeting, and I noticed myself checking out constantly because it wasn't something that really lit my fire. It wasn't part of my blueprint. It wasn't using my blueprint. So it didn't light my fire. Well, that begs the question, am I really serving the committee then? And I have to admit, I got into this committee because I felt obligated to serve. And this was one of the committees I was willing to serve, but I wasn't really interested in it. And this meeting, the topic of this meeting, I definitely wasn't interested in. So am I being honest to God in my serving? Not really. Because yes, I was there bodily, but I was checked out mentally. So again, the question is, God, where do you want me to serve? Whom do you want me to serve? And in what way? And it doesn't sound as selfless as you might think. You actually receive value when you serve in God's way. So again, all of this to say, we're not here for us. We're not here for others. We are here for God. And the amazing thing about God is when we do that, when we serve Him, we do serve others discriminately, and we also are served. So it's a very interesting line to walk. And again, knowing your blueprint, which is God's design for you, helps us answer those questions: where to serve, whom to serve, when to serve. So that's what we do here at Blueprint Process, is we help you identify your blueprint so you can know how you uniquely are meant to serve God.